right rear, trying to keep it from pushing sideways. I made this climb in a Pro Modified in 2019. I used a spotter strap to kind of drag him up the course, but he popped up real easy, but really had to kind of set the car and throttle. Keeping that tire or that rock out on the right rear. Settled it down. A nice job by that young man right there. Already a great save. Keeping this thing down on all four tires. You'd like to thank Carbon Off-Road and Raceline Wheels. Oh, and just sideways one more time. Oh, he is not able to keep it on the rubber. Oh, so close. The engine died out on him. He almost had it.
Five minutes, 58 seconds.
Yep, still plenty of time here. All the way over on the other side.
Wow, what an incredible competition. Getting out spotter straps, weighing down the car, doing whatever they can to drag that car up the rock or keep it from rolling.
Yeah, let's just go ahead and pull the curtain back a little bit. Oh, so close. All right, we're going to pull the curtain back just a little.
So Isaac didn't pull the rock out of the hole, so there might be something there to help.
Yeah, they are allowed to unstack. Got a 2 minute time limit. These guys are just following the textbook that they saw Matt and Isaac. I don't believe they've ever been to Farmington before this, so this is their first time on the Money Pit. Just warming up those BF Goodrich tires, trying to find a little bit of traction in there, working sideways and looking good. They are up the bottom section.
So that red line, there's a
step. They did kick the rock out.
These rocks aren't lightweight.
You got it.
No, just showing what a huge impact these spotters can have. There will be a lot of chiropractor and massage bills later this week. These guys giving it everything, not just physically, but mentally, emotionally, and everything the car has to throw at these obstacles here at the 2022 WeRock Grand Nationals presented by Maxxis Tires.
Thank you.
with the number of cones that they hit, but they do need to finish. So any misstep and the car kicks sideways, that could drop them down off the podium.
So they are taking a little bit of a different line.
off camber, car starting to slide downhill. Yeah, hopefully they'll find something to grab on back there. Saw John pull the front end of the car down. They've got an onboard electric winch. Typically use that for recovery, but in rock crawling. Grabbing the spotter straps, stack the rock in there to try and keep the tire away from the cone. And it's sitting down and a notch. John way sideways, way up top. He pulls it over. John finished. And he doesn't have the bonuses that he's accomplished so far. Got that three gate over there. I mean, he rolled while he was doing it, so I think that he gets at least style points.
Yeah.
Alright, down to 30 seconds.
Here we go.
Alright, nice easy drop down the bottom, just a few feet to the finish. Car stalled, it's backfired again. Working that front wheel all the way to the side, rear all the way as well. Headed to the finish gate. Let's take some risks. Going for the Mad Cow Racing.
Woo!
3, 2, 1, go!
Time has started. Chris is making his way up to the money pit. A lot of the time, even if Jesse's won already, he will still do as many of the bonuses as he can. So we may see a few bonuses. The money pit's good enough though for most. Typical hold of line when people start making this line. car, you just ran your tire just like you did on the rear.
Side. the C part.
Hey, let's take the photo. Wow, what a show.